one of my favorite persons is back in studio with me, Whitney Reynolds from Dream Team.
Hey, it is great to be back, and it's summertime.
Yes.
There's so many wonderful events coming in my inbox about Whitney's Women, so I'm honored to be here. And today, we have kind of an outdoor one that we're featuring, which is very appropriate for summertime. Nicole is my Whitney's
Hello.
Woman of the day. Welcome to the show.
Hello. Yeah, thanks for having me on.
Yeah, I am so glad you are here because you have an awesome event coming up. We also have the president of the organization that's in the studio. Hello, Scott. Welcome as well.
Thanks for having me, Whitney.
Yes, so tell us what the event is that's coming up.
So we have a celebrity golf outing that we are putting together benefiting the Helping Hands Network charity. It's a wonderful charity that was put together by Scott here and a couple other members that he's actually friends with over the years.
What is the Helping Hands Network for people that don't know Scott?
Sure, thanks, Whitney. The Helping Hands Network is an organization that was started with by Steve Hera and Mike Rosen and myself. And we raise money for a not-for-profit called Kesha. And what Kesha is doing is they're instrumental now in residential homes for young adults with developmental and intellectual disabilities. There's a huge problem right now in the state of Illinois and throughout the country for kids now that are becoming adults when they're ready to leave their home. In the past, as I explained to you earlier, there used to be a feeling that these kids should be bottled up or institutionalized. And now as our society has recognized that these children and young adults are becoming people with abilities rather than disabilities, we also see that they enjoy living in homes with friends and not just strangers in an institutional setting, trying to incorporate them into society and to give them a fulfillment in life that they otherwise wouldn't have.
I was going to say, because going back to this institutionalizing, because you're right, there has been a shift that has happened over the years, where now independence is really big, and people are actually looking at people with special needs as, you know, people. They're not putting them with labels and boxes, and this is a great movement that's going on. When did that shift happen?
I would say the shift happened with the explosion of autism. There's approximately 1.5 American adults with autism alone. And as we know from all the media and all the great autistic groups, there has just been an explosion of young adults, young children that become young adults that are autistic. We didn't see it when we were growing up, you know, in the 60s and the 70s. And now it's so prevalent throughout our society that I think what it's done is it's put such a strain on, like, the Department of Human Services and other governmental agencies that this was never anticipated, the need to find residential homes for these children, because what really happens is, as I get older, I have a son that's 22 that's autistic, and I have friends that are even older than I do, our worry really becomes what's going to come of our kids when we're gone.
Right.
And what we don't want to do is we don't want to burden their siblings, their typical siblings, with having to care for them or worry about where are they going to live. They're entitled to have their own lives while also having a certain amount of responsibility for their siblings with special needs. So this now, what we're focusing on, and there's a lot of folks throughout the country doing this, because really the government continues to shrink the ability to do this, as you see from the news media and all the cuts that are being made, is we're really focusing on trying to build this residential community for young adults with disabilities.
That is amazing. So this idea of the residential community, would it be in Chicagoland?
Sure. That's a great question. So the organization that we're supporting is called Kesha. And Kesha already has a terrific residential home in Highland Park, Illinois. It's called My Life. There's already 8 young adults living in that home. There's different degrees of disability, so some do need more care, some need less, but they are functioning within the community. So the beautiful thing about being in Highland Park is there's train stations, there's restaurants, there's stores, and the village in and of itself has taken these kids in, so they have a home, they go to work, they go grocery shopping, they go work out at one of the rec facilities, and they're also close to many other families that live in the vicinity. So it's just been a great thing, and what we're trying to do now is build phase 2 so more kids could get involved and more families could have an outlet in a residential facility.
Oh, that sounds just amazing. And it's beautiful to see barriers broken, to expand, to have hope for families, because like you were saying, having some personal knowledge on this, you don't know, like, as they get older, okay, what's going to happen? What's going to happen maybe when I'm not here to take care of them? And I think what a beautiful thing this home and it's now Nicole, there the charity golf fundraiser is coming up. We have some big names.
Yeah.
And it's going back to support this housing.
Yeah.
But tell us about the golf outing itself.
Now, this is my first year being involved in the charity, and what's great for me is to see us to come in and see everybody supporting it,
mm-hmm.
to see the big names of the celebrities come in and say, you know what, I'm going to devote my time to this day, and I'm just going to come out here and support, and that is great. So we have celebrities like, obviously, Jeremy Roenick is going to come out, and Brian Bickle's coming out from the Chicago Blackhawks organization, and Brandon Bolin's coming out. We also have past and present Bears players and more Blackhawks players. And then we have a number of sponsors that are well-known throughout the Chicagoland area that are donating time and it's their day to come out and help support. And we have different contests throughout the day, on course and off course, and all proceeds go to help the charity fund, like the housing that he talked about. And we have live auctions going on that support the housing. Like you can donate, pay like rent for the housing, utilities for the housing. So that's another way of giving, actually physically giving back to, instead of just if you didn't want to donate like a chunk of money towards.
And then are there still some openings where people can sign up to play?
Yeah, there is.
Okay, so tell us about the date and how people get involved.
Okay, so on July 20th at Twin Richards Country Club in Long Grove, we'll have a shotgun start at 12 noon. We have a website, helpinghandstoday.org. You can go there and register, or you can call our executive director, Trevor Brody. Okay, is it okay if I give his phone number?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Well, you know what? It might just be easier to say website. Repeat that one again.
Okay, helpinghandstoday.org. And our executive director is Trevor Brody. We'll always make room for folks that want to come. One thing I just want to add, too, is the thing that's been remarkable through all the years that we've done this, and particularly this year, is every celebrity that comes out of the goodness of their heart. These folks are not charging us. They're coming. They spend a day on the golf course as a fifth and a foursome. They make each golf experience really special. They add to the day, not only in their great golf skills, but just a different kind of vibe in terms of what they're trying to accomplish. And they are so well-versed in our charity and what our goals are. I think that's what draws many of these celebrities to us. And Jeremy Roenick has been with us from the get-go. He's a tremendous asset to our organization.
What is his connection with the organization?
So Jeremy and one of our co-founders, Steve Hera, have been like brothers for the last 25, 30 years. And when we started the organization, Steve reached out to Jeremy, and Jeremy was like, as long as it involves kids and young adults with disabilities, I'm on board, I'll do whatever it takes. And he's there for a phone call, he's there for whatever we need him for, and he's been an unbelievable ambassador for what we do.
You know, Robin, this is something beautiful about Chicago, because we always see our local celebrities, sports stars. I mean, we've seen this week after week, month after month on Whitney's Women, where people just get involved by the dozens because they want to help their local community, and that is just wonderful. So again, the date, real quick.
July 20th, it's a Thursday.
Okay, July 20th, and again, the website.
HelpingHandsToday.org.
Thank you both for joining me. And Nicole, thanks for being my Woman of the Week.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Yeah.
Awesome. So what do you have coming up?
Well, we are airing every Monday night at 6:30 on Lakeshore PBS. And so we are just working through our summer topics right now. People can always get caught up, though, if it's not a Monday, on WhitneyReynolds.com.
Thanks for joining me.
Thank you.
For more information, check out WhitneyReynolds.com or get social with us, Twitter @WhitneyReynolds or on Facebook, The Whitney Reynolds Show.